flying monkey from the cage, the witch, she used to say, "Fly, my pretty, fly." She doesn't say that now. She just says, "Fly, fly, fly." And again, with the boat, probably the 1930s or something, you could pull out your old VHS and if you guys have and put it in. She does not say, "Fly, my pretty, fly." She says, "Fly, fly, fly." Another big movie change, Terminator 2. You guys familiar with Terminator 2, I'm sure, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I want you to bring up the box art for it while I'm talking, okay? Terminator 2, if you look at it now, you can call it Terminator 2, Judgment Day. The word judgment has been Mandela affected. It's changed in the English language, and it's also changed on that Terminator poster, and the first E is missing. Look at the word judgment now. It only has one E instead of two. And that's also reflected in everybody's Bible. The word judgment in your Bible now only has one E. So what I was saying, Mike, is in the English language, the word judgment has actually changed. It's dropped the first E. It's reflected from that Terminator 2 box art. If you look at Terminator 2 Judgment Day, judgment is missing the first E. I know it looks off to you, even if you can't place right away what it is. The first E is missing in judgment, and that's also changed in everybody's Bibles. And I get Christians with this all the time, because they type judgment, which means it has one E. Another big movie change, Moonraker, James Bond movie. Iconic scene with Jaws smiling at Dolly, and Dolly smiles back, and she has these braces. She's never had braces now in any of those movies, in that movie in particular. Another, one of the biggest quotes to me that changed is the TV show. It's Mr. Rogers. Did you ever watch Mr. Rogers?
Yeah, I mean, a little bit.
I didn't really watch it. Yeah, it was, like, it was on, but...
Yeah. Okay. So, do you remember the start of the song, William? Have you seen the first couple lines?
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, right?
You'd be right. That's the memory I have.
That's what I thought. He comes to the door, right? He takes his sweater off. And he might have said, "Well, hello there," and then he goes, "It's another day, another beautiful day in the neighborhood."
Well, that's. I'm glad you brought that up. I'm going to talk about disinformation in a little bit. I know you want to talk about that too. That's actually some of the key of disinformation because it wasn't a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Okay? It got Mandela affected. Now when Mr. Rogers comes through the door, on all the old episodes, he says it's a beautiful day in this neighborhood instead of the neighborhood, like his particular neighborhood. It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood. Any parody that's ever been done is a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Eddie Murphy used to do the skit, Mr. Robbins' neighborhood on Saturday Night Live, the beautiful day in the neighborhood. Daniel Tiger Show, which is on PBS, his show, which has the same company that owns it, they sing the song the way I remember. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. So people would come up and say, "You guys are wrong, you Mandela Effect people. You know, it must have always been that." Even though if you ask them and they sing it, they'll say it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, but they can't accept that these changes are happening. So they'll look at it. And they'll know what we call taking the update. They'll remember what we remember. Then when you tell them that it's changed, they'll be like, "Oh, well, I must have been misremembering." And it's like, how many things do you think you've been misremembering down the list? The movie didn't have a title for a little bit. Tom Hanks is announced in it. He's shifty as that. He's involved in so many changes. And then they said on CNN, an article comes out that says, "Mr. Rogers' movie has a title. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood," named after the theme song. They leave a link, clicking back to the original theme song, he comes to the door and says this. The movie's title, what we remember, that we were told were all crazy.
Yeah, I mean, as I said, at a certain point, it's like, and some people might be arguing, like, saying, you know, semantics, it's this or that, but it's like, yeah, but why? Why do we all have that specific memory,
yeah.
You know?
Well, yeah. And that's why I come with the big stuff first with you guys. It's not just semantics, it's not just media changes, but if we're going to talk about it, we could go on to change about media, music changes, and all of it. But there's so much. Brand changes, like, you ever had a Soap Disco fuck something?
Yeah. Well, yeah.
Yeah, well, you think you did. You think you did, because it's never existed.
I know. That is one that, like, that one got to me, and that's one I bring up to people when I was listening to your episode, I brought up one of my coworkers, and he was so convinced he had his wife go and take a picture of their stuffing in the pantry. He's like, "Dude, I'm telling you, bro, this guy's crazy. He doesn't know what he's talking about." He's like, "You had called her up? took a picture, and sure enough, it's no longer, it's never been super so tough stuff.
No,
I think
it's crap.
We have
it's
that
crap.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's always been crap now. And I'm sorry, guys, you're not going to tell me that all my memories are wrong. I know specifically I had so and so about something. It was their most famous product. That's the only reason I ended up eating their French bread pizza and other things later. It's because I knew their stuffing was good.
You know what's weird, too, is, and I know I'm going back a tiny bit, but like I'm just thinking about The Wizard of Oz one, because that one, again, wasn't a movie that I spent a lot of time watching, but we've all seen The Wizard of Oz at some point in time or another. I would have 100% remembered the Scarecrow pairing. It's a bright silver gun. When you look it up, that six-shooter, it's a bright silver six-shooter. There's no hiding it. And then, like you said, the Tin Man, you know, some people remember the oil can or an axe, but now he's carrying a pipe wrench. And then the one that got me through the lion with that giant hammer, I don't remember any of that stuff, ever.
Yeah.
I don't hear, but like...
It's incremental. That's one of the important things when we get into theories in a little bit, is you see changes that are incremental. So that, for me, and I'll touch on a couple theories. As far as jumping from one timeline to another, or we all died, or there was this one big shift, or we're on a different Earth, none of that makes any sense to me. Because we have incremental changes that happen in front of us, like The Wizard of Oz. I'll tell you a quick story. Went to my buddy's house, just trying to wake him up for the Mandela effect. He's very perceptive to things I say, though. And I'm telling him about these guns, right? And he's like, you're telling me right now, I have this movie, the Scarecrow's gonna have a gun. I said, why, you have the movie? He said, yeah, I think I do have the movie. I said, well, you need to go get that movie right now. He got the movie, we popped it in, needless to say, Scarecrow had a gun. At that point, the flat metric fly had already changed. So we're looking at these changes, and we're looking for more things that are off, right? Mm-hmm. Nothing else was off. And then a few months later, 7, 8, 9 months later, the Tin Man got the giant pipe wrench, went back to his house, popped the movie in. I was able to show him the incremental change that now your own movie has changed again, right in front of us, and now he has this giant pipe wrench. Just like Star Wars has incremental. Star Wars has so many changes.
Yeah.
I'm a huge Star Wars guy. I don't know what you guys think. I'm not anymore. I don't watch the new stuff. But growing up, the original trilogy, I mean, I've seen it hundreds of times. C-3PO has a silver fucking leg now. C-3PO is all gold.
No,
all gold, please.
I will fight somebody over that one. I know there was, I know with what we're being told is now the truth, but like, he had a golden leg because that was the biggest thing about the Ewok celebrating him as a god lifted up in a chair and he was almost gold. I don't know.
If you look at that chair scene now, I'll bring it up real quick, because I do have that picture.
Yeah. And Micah, how do you remember him, by the way? Do you remember him all gold, or?
I do remember him all gold.
When you see this picture, he pulls this up, it sticks out.
I would be in
so
bad. Rewatch the first movie, because I've watched Phantom Menace, I don't know how many times, and I guarantee you I could pick out anything different from what I remember.
Yeah, these changes are just to the original trilogy that I'm speaking of. It's not for the Phantom Menace, so I'm not saying that this was a late in the Phantom Menace. But let me show you how ridiculous he looks in the Ewok village. And I'm going to show you some resume real quick after this. You guys are going to like this. So this is, and I'm talking about disinformation. Can you see the image?
Yeah.
Look at that. Come on, Micah. Come on. That would suck on it. Look at that, dude. That's like just blasphemous style.
What is
this?
Oh
my god.
Yeah, it's so funky. It's just.
Yeah, so here's the backstory, right? So all of a sudden, just like with all these other Mandela effects, people started to address them. So all of a sudden, in 2016 or 17, Anthony Daniels, the guy under the C-3PO costume, ends up in a USA Today video where they want to ask him what's up with his silver leg. And he's like, comes out in this interview, and he says, well, you know, it's funny, he says, I've always had the silver leg, and it's just, you know, it was always just reflected off the sand, so people thought it was gold, right? Well, you didn't get it, but he keeps going with what he said. Then he says, one day, I was on the set, and my film photographer, so we're talking about a Lucasfilm film photographer, probably the best camera in the world, right? So, my film photographer is taking my pictures one day, and he says, hey, Anthony, why do you have a silver leg today? And he says, I've always had it. Now, first of all, we know that's bullshit. Second of all, is this the sand? Is this reflecting on sand right now? No. Another thing that the deniers that Michael will say, well, C-3PO got blown apart and Chewbacca put him. C-3PO got blown apart and Empire Strikes Back halfway through the movie. I'm going to show you something now. Check this out. This image right here, this is from Princess Leia's ship in the opening scene of the movie. And he's already got the silver leg. It's not reflecting off sand and Chewbacca didn't put him back together. This is the first scene in the original Star Wars New Hope. He's got the silver leg now. Yeah, and some of the residue, so I talked about physical residue. Now, with Mandela effect, almost all official memorabilia of anything will change, right? Parodies will remain and things. Some things do have a lot of residue, like hostile powders, I'm going to show you something amazing too. And C-3PO, there's a lot of C-3PO all the residue. But I was actually able to find an official Kenner doll that I want to show you. I went to Huntington Beach, California, and I found this shop that was selling old figures and stuff, and they had some old Star Wars stuff. So I'm like, all right, first thing I'm going to do is look for residue. Now, just to be clear, the Phantom Menace came out in 1999. Now, remember, like I told you that this does not apply to those movies. It only applies to original trilogy. The reason I'm saying that is because I know the Phantom Menace doesn't have a silver leg, so that way, Mandela people, you can't use Phantom Menace or the other two movies as residue because it didn't change. Still the same, you know, the changes in the original trilogy. But look at the date on this doll I found. This guy was selling this, 1997, so obviously what I'm about to show you is representing the original trilogy, because the Phantom Menace hadn't come out. Okay? This is Kenner. They had the official license for the C-3PO figures. Even when I was a little boy, they made all the figures. Now, let me just move this a little bit out of my way. Look at that. That's me holding it.
That was pretty gold.
Collective theory, officially from Kenner, all gold. Now, how could you make a mistake like that? Like, why would that even happen? Why would they, this intricate doll that I'm going to paint the legs the right color? Now, let me ask you a question, guys. They had huge style and then you copy the doll and they beat the fuck out on it. Do you think they show up with these real coffins and silver legs, or do you think they go all gold?
Always gold. I mean, that's the thing. You said, I mean, Star Wars is one of the most cosplay things out there. And so, you never see somebody walk around and say, like, maybe now, but like, it's always been gold. Gold. It's been shit. It was been gold.
Gold. Now, another huge change with Star Wars is at the end of A New Hope, and then I'll get off Star Wars and do some other stuff, but another huge change with Star Wars is at the end of A New Hope, there was a famous scene. Han Solo, Luke Skywalker, and Chewbacca all approached this podium, and Princess Leia, I think she started with Han first, it might have been Luke, it might have flipped, but Han comes up, he bends his head down, Han comes up, she kisses him on the cheek, he bends his head down, and she puts a medal over his neck. Luke comes up, she kisses him on the cheek, he bends his head down, and she puts a medal over his neck. Now the next thing, what I remember happening, Chewbacca came up, he didn't get a kiss on his cheek, so tall, you know, 9 feet tall, he had to bend way down like this. Princess Leia puts a medal on his neck, Chewbacca looks up at the sky, roars, and it cuts the credits to show him the star. That's what I remember. In this reality, Chewbacca never even gets a medal. It's completely gone.
Yeah, I know. That bothers me too, because that's how I remember it, was they all laugh. And as he's roaring, they kind of all laugh. They kind of like chuckle and instead of cut straight to Star Wars. I don't know. I definitely, with the Star Wars one, and that's what's so funny is everybody, when they bring up the Mandela, like, oh, top 40, they're like, you know, did he say, Luke, I am your father? No. And that's the one they bring up. I'm like, dude, I don't even
agree with that one. And people might get triggered because I'm like, the Mandela guy, I didn't even agree with that one. He was always, no, I am your father. He was never Luke, I am your father.
Right.
For me.
Yeah.
But I could be wrong because, well, we've seen incremental changes, we've seen things that have had three, four versions.